Here's what we in America ought to hate. Ungrateful motherfuckers. George W. Bush is one ungrateful motherfucker. Here he is, our goddamned president, who every time he has stumbled in his life, every time he has faced adversity or failure, has had a goose-down pillow waiting for his ass when he hit the ground. We who hate Bush hate him because he acts as if his stupid-ass luck of being born into one of the most powerful families in the world entitles him to be a complete motherfucker. From getting into Yale, to getting out of his guard duties, to winning the presidency on a fluke, Bush ought to be the most humble, grateful man in the world. Instead, he acts as if he's somehow something more than a privileged pussy, pampered and powdered, looked after like the favorite poodle. And we who recognize this just want to see him get his comeuppance. 'Cause once this bag of douche is out of office, he will be abandoned by everyone around him. And maybe, just maybe, he'll get his fate of being forced to be his daddy's manservant, washing Poppy's balls when Poppy gets so old he can't even scratch himself. Some days, you gotta pity Laura Bush. Imagine being married to one of the most despised men in the world, someone who's done nothing short of wreck centuries of American progress, someone who knows he's in over his head. Imagine all the weeping and praying she has to deal with, all the time she has to say like a mantra,
"Jesus will show us the way. Jesus will show us the way."
As she conspires with the Secret Service to lock the sweet liquor in the basement. As she disconnects the phone so her husband can't call old contacts to get him some blow. Pity her for all the time she's had to place the president's cock in her mouth, sucking for all she's worth, reciting the Dewey Decimal System in her head as she mindlessly bobs until her husband's polluted, oily seed infects her mouth once more. Pity her for laying on the French linen on her stomach after having been roughly fucked in the ass one more time with the president shouting,
"Oh yeah, say you're Saddam, say you're Saddam!"
As he smacks her ass with Laura thinking,
"At least I didn't have to wear the mustache this time."
While George calls his mother after it's over to weep to Babs that he did another bad thing, a habit he's had since he fucked passed out sorority girls at Yale. And speaking of passed out sorority girls, man, I wanna fuck the Bush twins. I want a Jenna and Babs sandwich. I want Babs sitting on my face while Jenna bobs on my crank. I want to fuck them hard. I want to fuck them ugly. I love that their names sound like porno names without even playing the porno name game. I got so hot about the Bush twins when they were out on the campaign trail, talking up the policies of their father, offering heartwarming stories about what a good dad he is, smiling like a couple of $20 a fuck hookers who just love their pimp because he treats them so much better than the other pimps treat their whores. At the Republican convention, the Bush twins demonstrated for the world to see that they are destined for coked-out oblivion, being the fuck puppets for celebrity boys who want to tell their posses they had presidential pussy. When Jenna said that it was time for payback for being embarrassed by their parents, God, didn't you just hope against hope that some synapse would flare up in her brain and she'd say,
"Holy fucking shit. There was the night Daddy came home, blasted out of his mind on Peruvian blow and tequila, and chased me around wearing nothing but a cowboy hat and boots and a raging hard-on, screaming, 'Daddy loves you, Daddy loves you, you got a loving Daddy.' And my mom had to pull out a rifle and tell him to put his pants on or she was gonna call Grandma. And then Daddy collapsed by the pool, pissing himself and screaming, 'Mama's gonna beat me something fierce,' before he vomited down his chest and all over the Spanish tile. And when he started bleeding out of his nose, Mom called Grandpa, who sent over his private ambulance, the one on call for just this emergency, to take my Daddy to the hospital to pump him with adrenaline so he didn't go into a coma and embarrass everyone. Again."
Yeah, and at night, after a hard half day at the Oval Office, Daddy, martini glass, a tonic water in hand, can turn on Fox News and watch a video of his little girls talking about how much they love their daddy. And like so many men in America, he can stick his hand in his unzipped pants and think,
"Oh, daddy loves his little girls. Oh, how daddy loves his little girls."
This just in, Scooter Libby raped in prison. Former vice presidential aide Scooter Libby was gang raped by a group of conservative activists led by Karl Rove. Libby was heard to cry out, "Please God, not in the face, Carl," before his muffled yells went silent. Rove was once more placed into solitary confinement pending another investigation.